the game. Come on, raise the game. Are you ready? He gives us everything we could ever need to love the world around us, to be a light in darkness. He's with us every breath, he's with us every step, so we can leave fear in the dust behind us. If you wanna raise the game, he will give you strength to reach another level in Jesus' name. If you wanna raise the game, he will give you strength to reach another level in Jesus' name. We are moving up, moving up. We are making it loud. We're making it loud. Us everything we could ever need to love the world around us, to be a light in darkness. He's with us every breath, he's with us every step, so we can leave fear in the dust behind us. If you wanna raise the game, he will give you strength to reach another level in Jesus' name. If you wanna raise the
Good morning, parents of preschoolers. This month, we continue with the incredible truth, I can believe in Jesus. This truth is so powerful that we will continue asking the question, who can believe in Jesus? So our preschoolers will know, I can believe in Jesus. It's hard to imagine, but one day our preschoolers will make a choice that they think is so bad they'll wonder if Jesus still loves them. Or they'll leave a classroom wrestling with what their teacher or their professor just taught and how it fits with what they believe. We want them to believe Jesus is real and know that he loves them no matter what. Jesus is who he said he is, and he wants to be their friend forever. There is such beauty for preschoolers to know that they're loved forever, no matter what. And now, to all of my sweet preschoolers out there, happy, beautiful, sunny Sunday morning. Well, at least I hope it's sunny outside right now. Why don't you go look out your window? Is the sun outside? I can't see it from my window. I'm so grateful that God created summer and sunshine and that we can go outside and do fun things like jump on a trampoline, run through a sprinkler, or go for a bike ride. I think all of those things are gifts that God gives us every single day, even when we don't realize it. He is the one who creates the warmth of the sun, the refreshing rain, and the scent of flowers, and he has given those things to us to enjoy. So today, be sure to go outside and thank the Lord for all the things that he's given you and for the blessing to be able to enjoy them. He is a father who gives good gifts to his children, and being able to enjoy summer is a good gift to you. Do you have your Bible with you this morning? I hope you do, because your Bible is a powerful tool. Did you know that your Bible is a weapon? When you read in the pages of the Bible, it says the word of the Lord is a sword, because with the word, you can do battle against the devil and all of his evil plans. So hold up your Bible so that I can see it. Now that's very good. Now it's a good time for us to go over our new memory verse for the month of July. Are you ready? These are written so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God. John 20:31. This was last month's memory verse as well, so I know you know it, so say it with me again. In fact, I want you to stand to your feet and say it. Are you ready? These are written so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God. John 20:31. That was fun. Thanks for saying it with me. So you can go ahead and have a seat now, and we will go over the word and learn something new this morning. Now, we've been learning that Jesus loves everyone, and I got to wondering, do you think that really means everyone? Does Jesus really love everyone no matter what? Well, I have a true story from the Bible, and it will help us answer that question. When Jesus was teaching people how to love each other, he had a good friend named Peter. Jesus and Peter spent a lot of time together, and Jesus taught Peter about God's love. Jesus also let Peter help him do important jobs, like one time they fed thousands of people with just one boy's lunch. Imagine thousands of people sitting on a hillside, all of them eating out of just one lunch bag. Can you imagine how amazing that was to help Jesus feed all of those people with just the one lunch? Wow. Jesus and Peter would even go fishing together. Jesus and Peter were great friends. Then one night, some angry soldiers took Jesus away and they hurt Jesus and they said mean things to him. This scared Jesus' friends, so they ran away. But Peter wanted to see what would happen, so he followed Jesus and the angry soldiers. While Peter waited to see what would happen, a girl asked him if he was Jesus' friend. Peter was so scared that he said no. Peter said he was not Jesus' friend. That's very sad. Peter lied and he denied his best friend, his teacher, his Lord, because he was scared. A little while later, another person asked Peter if he was Jesus' friend. And guess what Peter said this time? He said no. That's two times Peter said that he was not Jesus' friend, and that's very, very sad. Then another person asked Peter if he was Jesus' friend, and guess what he said this time? He said no again. That's three times Peter said that he was not Jesus' friend. That's very, very, very sad. After the third time, Peter looked over and saw Jesus looking at him, and Peter knew saying that he was not Jesus' friend was wrong. He felt so bad that he went away and he cried. But wait, that's not the end of the story. Later, after Jesus died and came back, Jesus went to Peter and talked to him. Jesus still loved Peter no matter what, even though Peter said he was not Jesus' friend. Jesus wanted Peter to know that he would be his friend forever, no matter what. And knowing that Jesus still loved Peter and that they were still good friends made Peter so happy. And from that day on, Peter told everyone everywhere that Jesus is God's son. Peter told everyone that Jesus is alive, that he loves them, and that he wants to be their friend forever. So many people believed in Jesus because of Peter. And guess what? You can believe in Jesus too. It's true, because Jesus loves everyone. So tell me, who can believe in Jesus? Our bottom line, I can believe in Jesus. What an awesome thing that we can love Jesus and we can also tell others about Jesus. So will you please close your eyes and talk with me to God together? Dear Jesus, we love you so much. Thank you that no matter what we do, no matter what we say, you will love us and you will be with us forever. Thank you that you walk with us, that you talk with us, and that you take care of us. I pray for every little heart that is listening this morning that you will talk to them and that they will know that you are their friend and that you will always love them. Protect us as we go forward this day and be with us. And we pray this in the powerful name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, all of my little preschoolers, for joining again this morning. I hope you have a wonderful weekend. I hope you had a great 4th of July, and we'll see you next week. We are back together again for another Sunday morning look at faith and what it means to have faith. We talked all through the month of June about faith, and we're continuing our lesson on faith through the hot month of July. Do you remember what faith is? I will start the sentence and you finish it. Are you ready? Faith is... Okay, some of you were mumbling and some of you just sat there and stared at me. Let's try this again. Faith is trusting in what you can't see because of what you can see. Sure, we can't see Jesus with our eyes, but we can put our faith in Jesus because we know who he is and what he's done. When we put our focus on Jesus, we start to understand how good he is. We realize that we can trust him completely. That, my friends, is a gift. So let's pick up where we are in God's big story. We're talking about what happened with the people who believed in Jesus after Jesus died and came back to life and then went to heaven. We've talked a lot about recently about a man named Paul, who was also called Saul. Paul traveled around and shared the message of Jesus with people all over the place. He also wrote a bunch of letters to encourage the believers in different churches. Many of his letters became books of the Bible. One of Paul's letters was to the people in Ephesus. We call it the book of Ephesians. Let's read a part of it. I want you to open your Bibles to Ephesians 2, 8 through 9. God's grace has saved you because of your faith in Christ. Your salvation doesn't come from anything you do. It is God's gift. It is not based on anything you've done. No one can brag about earning it. Now, I bet the Ephesians needed to hear that. I know I do. You see, we all mess up. We make mistakes. We fail at things. We don't do things we know we're supposed to do that can make us feel pretty crummy about ourselves. When we look at the people around us, that can make us feel like we've messed up. We think, I wish I could be more like him, or she always does everything perfectly. It can seem like everyone else has it all together and never messes up like I do, and that can especially seem true when we're at church. But the truth is, everyone has messed up. Even though other people may seem to have everything all together and seem to do everything right, that's just not the case. Nobody is perfect except Jesus. We all mess up. Sometimes we feel like we have to fix things when we've done something wrong. So we don't ask for help and we don't let God fix anything. We try to fix it ourselves. We might try to make up for what we've done wrong, and we can try to cover it up by doing good things, or we can try to hide it from others. We can try to do a lot of good things to make up for the bad things we've done. But the truth is, none of that makes the bad things go away. Here's the really good news. It's not your job to fix what's wrong. That's why God sent Jesus. We don't have to do everything perfectly to fit in. God loves you and accepts you no matter what you've done or will do. You can't work to earn his love. That is so huge. I'm going to say it again, and I want to make sure you're listening and that you hear me. Lean in really close so you do not miss my words. God loves you and accepts you no matter what you've done or will do. You can't work to earn his love. Everyone messes up. Everyone. It's easy for us to think everyone else seems better than us, but they aren't. We all mess up and make mistakes. That's why God gave us the best gift ever when he gave us Jesus. So let's take another look at what Paul wrote in his letter. This happens to be our memory verse for the month of July. God's grace has saved you because of your faith in Christ. Your salvation doesn't come from anything you do. It's God's gift. Let's stop there. Salvation is God's gift. That means that when we put our trust in Jesus, God forgives us all the wrong things we've done and will do. When we put our faith in Jesus, we believe that He died on the cross to pay the price for our sins. He paid the price for every single sin we've already committed and every sin we will ever commit in the future. Jesus did all of the work of paying for our sins. We didn't do anything. That means that there's nothing we can do to earn God's love, and there's nothing we can do that will cause Him not to love us. Jesus paid for our sin and made us right with God, and that is a free gift. This brings us to our bottom line for the month of July. Jesus is a gift for everyone. He fixes the mess we've made and turns it into something beautiful. Of course, as we follow Jesus, we're gonna mess up. And when we do, we can say we're sorry and accept God's forgiveness that we have through Jesus. We should always try to live the way God wants us to. We should always try to make the wise choice. We should always try to do the right thing. We should always do our best to treat others with love and kindness. But we don't do these things just to earn something. We do these things, good things, because we already know how much God loves us. Every day we can choose to live His way because we're so thankful that He sent Jesus to be our Savior. That's the great news. Jesus is a gift for everyone. So will you please join me as I pray over you and that the seed of this word will take root in your hearts and in your minds. Jesus, thank you so much that you love us, that your Spirit is always with us, that there's nothing we can do that can separate us from the love of Christ. I thank you that you are with us, and I pray today that every heart that is listening will know you and love you and walk with you. I pray protection over all of us. We love you, Jesus, and we give this day to you, and we pray it in your name. Amen. Thank you, all of my kids who have joined this morning. I hope you had a really good 4th of July. I can't wait to see you in person one day, but in the meantime, have a great week, and I'll see you next week.